Good evening, and thank you for attending tonight's event. My name is Nancy Seaman, and I'm a prisoner at Women's Huron Valley Correctional Facility, where I've been incarcerated for the past 14 years for the homicide of my abusive husband, Bob Seaman. I was once the face of every woman, a wife, mother, sister, daughter, friend, co-worker, neighbor, and elementary school teacher. I was Cub Scout den mother to your sons, and I likely sat next to you in the bleachers cheering at our children's sporting events. Now I'm a convicted murderer. Unlike Francine Hughes of the Burning Bed, who did not go to prison, I'm serving a sentence of life with no chance for freedom. I choke back tears just saying those words. I'm not a criminal, but a survivor of domestic abuse. I did not premeditate to kill my husband. I only premeditated to safely leave Bob without confrontation. With the financial support of my father and moral support of both my sons, I secretly purchased a condo and began moving my possessions from our home. Somehow, Bob discovered my plans. But he waited until the morning of May 10, 2004, to confront me about what he had discovered. A verbal altercation about my plans to leave turned violent, and I was chased to the garage and knocked to the floor. As I laid on the garage floor, Bob paced, spewing his vitriol of verbal abuse while he periodically approached to batter me. At barely 5'2" and 110 pounds, I was no match for Bob, 189 pounds of rage. I had no hope that I could escape Bob's grip and every expectation that he would overpower me as he always had before. When Bob put his hands on me that final time, said, "I'll see you dead," flashbacks of the abuse and threats I'd endured in the preceding months flooded my mind and colored the lens through which I viewed the present attack. I had no doubt I was in danger. In a panic frenzy, I defended myself, and my blows were deadly. Unlike Francine Hughes, I didn't call the police. It never entered my mind. I suppose that's because in my two previous contacts with the police, after having been battered, they offered no help. I was unable to think clearly. Rational thought wasn't possible. Instead, I slipped into the same autopilot behavior that had allowed me to cope with Bob's abuse during all those years of our marriage. I simply denied the reality of what had happened, covered up any evidence of it, and went about life as if nothing ever happened. When my son was notified by the police that a tragedy had occurred in our family, he recalls that his first thought was that his father had killed his mother and then killed himself. That remark tells the whole story. Those who knew Bob and I well feared not for his life, but for mine. Trial evidence supported my claim of self-defense. The autopsy showed alcohol and amphetamines in Bob's system, which likely fueled his rage, and the pathology report confirmed it was a face-to-face confrontation, not the ambush the prosecutor claimed. The numerous bruises on my arms and legs at the time of arrest were classified as defensive injuries by the state nurse examiner, who testified that defensive injuries are injuries a person receives when they try to protect themselves from being injured further. Still, I was convicted of first-degree murder. Now only the governor can release me from prison. 5 months after I was sentenced, Judge McDonald, who presided over my trial, believed I did not premeditate to kill my husband, and he overturned the jury verdict. 5 years later, federal judge Bernard Friedman did the same. After hearing all the evidence, Dr. Lenore Walker, the foremost authority on battered women's syndrome and expert witness at my trial, was not allowed to present to the jury because of an archaic law called People v. Christel. Dr. Walker has stated, "I testified in over 500 trials in 35 states, and never was my testimony so limited as it was in the state of Michigan." Both Judge McDonald and Judge Friedman support my release from prison. Please support the release of battered women who have been unjustly incarcerated for defending their lives from attack from their abusers, and support legislative change to the law People v. Christel. Thank you for your attendance tonight and your support.